Good day, my dear third class students. We have already about 6 video recordings for you. I hope you had an opportunity to view them. This is the 7th one. I am going to teach you in the subject social, the lesson 2, the physical elements of the earth. There will be a lot of reading rather than me teaching. Prior to that, I want to tell you that you need to have the textbooks. You have to get the textbooks. Talk to your parents and get the textbooks and the study materials so that you can follow the videos very easily. And then, of course, answer all the questions that you have in the booklets. So, once again, you make sure you touch your parents and get the textbooks. And we will continue recording these lessons, whether the corona is there or not. When the school reopens, we don't know yet. They say it's September, but it could be even December, as stated by the center. So anyway, we do not want our students to lose the academic year. So we continue to teach, and I request all the students to watch the video. And whenever you have a doubt, send the question by WhatsApp. That is the easiest. Make a photograph, scribble on a piece of paper. Make a photograph and then send it by WhatsApp. So, as usual, in any subject, in Srijana teaching, the student as a total has to read a lesson 7 times. The teacher will read 2 or 3 times and the rest of it by the students. Here, I would like to read the lesson in few minutes, and when I read, I want you to follow how I am pronouncing the words. I will also tell the meanings of the words in Telugu also. So, as a first time reading, I am going to start it. I will highlight some of the difficult words and also pronounce the difficult words, so you watch them. So if you look at page 10 of your third class Elements of Social Studies book, page 10, if you look at it, you will see a world map. This is like an outline map. Now I will show you the world map. You can see the world map in color, and we will read this, we'll study this more in the following lessons. I just want to show you what the world map looks like. You can see here North America, South America, the Europe and the Asia, Africa, Australia and Antarctica at the bottom. So once again, you see here, this is North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, Asia, South Africa, and Australia. We'll study this more. This is a map. There is another one called globe. Globe is a round one. I'll show you the globe in the next part 2 of the presentation. Here, let me read that. A map, first of all, the one I showed you is a map. Map is a diagrammatic representation of an area, of a land and water, highlighting all the rivers, mountains, buildings, cities, etc. That's what a map is about. And in the case of a globe, map is a flat one. Globe is a real representation of Earth. Earth is like a globe, it's like a ball. So, we'll study the globe a little bit more in the next a lesson. Okay. Now, in the map, let me read the first page, page 10. Okay. The earth. Lesson 2, physical elements of earth. Model of earth. The earth's surface is not alike everywhere. It is not the same everywhere. Sometimes you have a mountain, sometimes you have a land, sometimes you have water, like that. That's what it means. It varies from place to place with the land and water bodies, lowlands, takuve, and then vast plains, visalamainatvanti, maidanalu, high mountains, ettaina, parvatalu, hills, kondalu, plateaus, petabhumulu, forests, adavulu, rivers, nadulu, seas, samudralu, lakes, sarasulu, etc. So, earth has all these items. Once again, earth has water bodies, land and water bodies, lowlands, vast plains, high mountains, hills, plateaus, forests, rivers, seas, lakes, etc. These are known as physical elements of the earth. Elements of the earth, physical elements. Physical ya chanabada, on the guilty, which means physical elements under. Elements of the earth. And earth lo, unatvanti, bhaga. Almost you can say bhaga. So, it is not possible for us to visit every place on the earth. Yala unnan munna alamala, manu anta, matta anta, earth anta manu chodam. Similarly, to go into the space, to see the earth from there. Alaya adevithanga, space lo kella akarnani mottam. Prapanchan antakni manam chodam. Arthamainda? For a better understanding about the earth, let us see a model of the earth that is a globe. I think I showed you the globe. You might have seen a globe in your school. In the last year's class, you must have studied about this globe. You must have seen the globe. We have several globes, and I will show you more importantly, more. I will discuss about the globe more in the next presentation. Since it is round in shape, like the earth, we can see only one half of the earth. When you take a ball, you can see only one half of the ball. On the other side, you cannot see. That's what it means. Half of the earth. Of course, if rotated, when it is rotated, you can see the second half also can be seen. Okay. So, that's what it says. So, in the first paragraph, we learned about what are the physical elements of earth. Earth lo unnatundi bhagalanninu. Samudralu, rivers, lakes, hills, mountains, petabhumulu, lands, rakarakalu anninu, avi manaki telusukunnam first paragraph lo. There are many maps, such as the world map. The one I showed you is a world map, map of Asia, map of India, physical maps, political maps, outland maps, etc. There are so many types of maps. Now, they may represent the whole world or a part of it. They may represent the whole world. Just like the map that I showed you is a world map, it shows the entire world. Or if you take only the Asia map, it shows only Asia. Similarly, India. Similarly, Visakhapatnam or Andhra Pradesh, like that. Okay. Now I move on to the page 11, the directions. The directions are, if you look at an A4 sheet, this is an A4 sheet, and if you draw the map of India, or something like this, okay? So, this is the representation is, this is the north, and this is the south, and this is the east, this is west. These are the four directions. So, there are four directions. You can see in the map here, this is page number 11, you can see India map, and on that you see the north-south directions. So, this is a map, India map, where you have Himalayas, Nepal, Pakistan, like that, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, Myanmar, and Burma. That's what is Burma, Bangladesh, and all that. Now, importantly, I'm telling about the directions. The map always, it is a usual practice to show the directions north, south, east, west on the upper right hand corner. In this map, it's shown in the middle. That's okay. Now, here it, what it says is always the upper part, upper side of the map indicates the north. The map in this upper side indicates the north. And always the lower part of the map denotes the south. So this is the south. So this is the north. So show you in the north and south here. Similarly, the left side of the map always points to the left side. When you look at it like this, left side is this. So this is the west. And on the right side of the map always indicates east. Eastern Devantamano, idi Turpu, idi Uttara, idi Dakshina, idi Padamara. Telugulo ala antam. Telugulo ayyante Turpu, Padamara, Uttara, Dakshina. Or if you start in the English one maatladetappudu, entantam North, Uttara, Dakshina, East, Turpu, Padamara. Those are the four primary directions. Four primary directions. Then you have northeast to southeast to like that. That is the Ajneyo and Isanyo, that we will read about that later. Parts of the earth. If you look at the globe and the world map, you will find the following things. There are lines from the north to the south and west to east. There are lines from north to south and then west to east. The north to south, they are called longitudes. That's what it is, longitudes. N-O, the way I remember is N-O-R-T-H, north. In this you have the O. O, so that means it is a longitude. And then east-west, that's how I remember, okay? You don't have to, E is there, this is latitude, so this is A. So that's how I remember. When you see east, east-west, then it is a latitude. And it is north to south, it is called a longitude. There is O here, that's how. Then it is the Bandagutanta. Somehow, you should not get confused what is latitude and what is longitude. Latitude means there is E, that means east to west. And on the longitude, there is O, that means it is north to south. Okay, that's what it is. Now, let's move on. The latitudes are Achamsalu. Now I am moving to page number 12. Okay. Here, various places with different colors represent the parts of land surface. Colors, that's color work. And one state code called, another state code called, and Teliyadaniki. And if you color bed, but this state is not the same, then you can start with the same. And then you can start with the state. Tamil Nadu is easy to identify. So you color the map based on what kind of divisions you want. A large area with blue color shows water bodies. A map like that, blue color is the water bodies. A place of land surrounded by water on all the four sides. Island. An island is a country or a place which is surrounded by water on all the sides. That's, for example, Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is surrounded by water on all the four sides. Alage, Andaman, Nicobar Islands. Whereas here, a piece of land surrounded by water on four sides is called an island, that is Sri Lanka and Andaman and Nicobar Island. That's what I told. Then a piece of land surrounded by water on three sides and land on one side is called a peninsula. Peninsula, that is the India. You can see here, for example, if you look at the map of India, this is the Arabian Sea. You see that? This is the Arabian Sea. This is the Bay of Bengal. This is the Indian Ocean here. That's not written here. So, on one side, on the east side, you have the Bay of Bengal. On the west side, you have Arabian Sea. On the south side, you have Indian Ocean. So, but here, on the north side, you have the Himachal Pradesh, Pakistan, and other land. So, India is covered by water on three sides. You see, on the west side, Arabian Sea. on the south side, Indian Ocean, and then the other one is on the east side, Bay of Bengal. That's why India is called Peninsula. Peninsula ante telugu lo entam dvipa kalpamu island ni dvipa antam. Now water body, the blue colored large area on the globe represents water bodies. Blue colored ante antunnam nearly 71% of earth surface is covered by water. Ante enti ఆల్మోస్ట్ 3/4 అనుకోండి, 3/4 ఆల్మోస్ట్ వాటర్తోనే నిండిపోయిందట. ది రిమైనింగ్ 29% ఆఫ్ ల్యాండ్ ఏరియా ఈజ్ ల్యాండ్, మిగతాదేమో ల్యాండ్. ద లార్జ్ వాటర్ బాడీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఓషన్స్. ఓషన్స్ అంటే మహాసముద్రాలు, మహాసముద్రాలు. దర్ ఆర్ ఫోర్, నేమ్లీ ది పసిఫిక్ ఓషన్, ది అట్లాంటిక్ ఓషన్, ది ఇండియన్ ఓషన్ అండ్ ది ఆర్కిటిక్ ఓషన్. దర్ ఆర్ ఫోర్ మెయిన్ ఓషన్స్. ఏదేంటన్నాడు, ఇదేమంటే పసిఫిక్ ఓషను, అట్లాంటిక్ ఓషను, ఇండియన్ ఓషను అండ్ ఆర్కిటిక్ ఓషన్. నౌ సమ్ టైమ్స్ ది పోర్షన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది పసిఫిక్ అండ్ ది అట్లాంటిక్ అండ్ ది ఇండియన్ ఓషన్ అరౌండ్ ది అంటార్క్టికా ఆర్ కాల్డ్ అంటార్క్టిక్ ఓషన్. ఇవన్నీ కలిపి ఒకసారి అంటుంటారట. ఆ ఓషన్ అది సౌత్ సదరన్ ఓషన్. ద లార్జ్, సో వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్, ఐ విల్ రీడ్ అగైన్. Sometimes the portions of the Pacific, the Atlantic and Indian oceans around the Antarctica are called as the Antarctic Ocean or the Southern Ocean, Antarctica. The largest and deepest ocean is the Pacific Ocean and the smallest is the Arctic Ocean. What is the largest and deepest? That is the Pacific Ocean. That is the smallest is the Arctic Ocean. Now all these water bodies are connected to each other. Even the water bodies, they are connected to, by each other. Oceans separate the land and the masses. The ocean is just saying, they separate the land and the masses. Now small water bodies are called seas. Samudra, chin samudra or something. Small water bodies. The large water bodies are now oceans are now. Now the water in seas and oceans is salty. Salty ante uppaga untadi. Mana visapatna appudu enti ava evaru nillali evaru nilte aa water ni taste chesthe nu telustadi adi uppuga untadi. Mana we cannot drink it, it's so salty. We have many uses with the ocean. Oceans valla manaku chaala chaala upayogalu unnai. They are the sources of salt. Salt water taru vastadi. Fisheries, వాళ్ళు చేపలు అనేటువంటి సముద్ర చేపలు అంటారు. సముద్ర చేపలు, చెరువు చేపలు, సముద్ర చేపలు చాలా దొరుకుతాయి. తర్వాత పెరల్స్, ముత్యాలు. ఆడవాళ్ళు మెడలో వాయిస్తారు పెరల్స్, తెల్లగా ఉంటాయి పెరల్స్. మెనీ మెనీ మెటల్స్, చాలా లోహాలు అండ్ పెట్రోలియం. సముద్రం నుండి సముద్రాన్ని పెట్రోలియం కూడా తీస్తారు. అండ్ ఆల్సో వీ యూజ్ దెమ్ యాజ్ వాటర్ వేస్ట్, యాజ్ వాటర్ వేస్ట్. వాటర్ వేస్ట్ అంటే అర్థం ఏంటి? ఇప్పుడు దేర్ ఆర్ త్రీ ఆర్ ఫోర్ ల్యాండ్ వేస్ట్, ఎయిర్ వేస్ట్, వాటర్ వేస్ట్. So when people want to move or things have to be moved from one place to another place, we have different things. First of all, on land alachu, like for the air alachu, then the water land. So ee samudralu valla water waste kodunu. Suppose something has to come from America to India, it can come by water. Water amo chala iyochu. That is the cheapest mode of transport. Just like Airways is the most expensive. అందుకని తక్కువ, అన్నిటికంటే తక్కువ ఏంటి? వాటర్ వేస్ట్. సముద్రం మీద వచ్చిన వాటర్ వేస్ట్. ల్యాండ్ మాస్, 29% ఆఫ్ ద టోటల్ ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ద ల్యాండ్ పార్ట్ ఈజ్ డివైడెడ్ ఇన్ టు 7 కాంటినెంట్స్. ఏంటంటే దే ఆర్ ఏషియా, యూరప్, ఆఫ్రికా, నార్త్ అమెరికా, ది సౌత్ అమెరికా, ఆస్ట్రేలియా అండ్ అంటార్క్టికా. అంటే ఏంటి, మొత్తం లోపు తీసుకుంటే యూ హ్యావ్ సముద్రాలు, ఓషన్స్ ఉన్నాయి, సీస్ ఉన్నాయి అండ్ దెన్ ల్యాండ్. ల్యాండ్ని ఏం చేశారు, 7 పార్ట్లు డివైడ్ చేశారు. అవే పార్ట్లు ఏంటంటే ఇక్కడ ఏషియా, యూరప్, ఆఫ్రికా, నార్త్ అమెరికా, ది సౌత్ అమెరికా, ఆస్ట్రేలియా అండ్ అంటార్క్టికా. ద లార్జెస్ట్ కాంటినెంట్ ఈజ్ ఏషియా, లార్జెస్ట్ కాంటినెంట్. జస్ట్ లైక్ ద లార్జెస్ట్ ఓషన్ ఈజ్ పసిఫిక్ ఓషన్ అన్నాం, అలాగే ఇక్కడ కూడా largest continent is Asia and the smallest is Australia. Australia beautiful. America kena chaala baaguntundi antaru. Nenu elda anukunnanu avale I could not go. At one time, I narrowly missed. I would love to go, but I could not make it. When I'm working for a company in United States, we had a project in Australia. I'm almost to go, but due to some reason, I don't remember the reason why, but I could not make it. I wish I could go and see Australia. People say very, very, very good about Australia, its beauty and how well it is maintained, how neat it is, how beautiful it is. Anyway, let me move on. We can see the different parts of landform on the surface. Landform vegetative, mountains, hills, plateaus, plains, valleys, rivers, valleys and lowlands. Rivers, forests, deserts and also, Yadalu, deltas, lakes, islands, peninsulas, etc. Even you don't know. Yadalu, land forms. Death is only the shelter of all of us. Death is the only shelter. There are several planets. You must have read it in the previous lesson, or you are going to learn about them. There are, what is it, Mars, Neptune, so forth, Pluto, like that. Several planets are there. But the Earth is the only one where people can live because it has water and air. Okay? Now let me see. The Earth is the only shelter for all of us. So we have to protect it. So the summary is, Earth consists of two parts. One is 71% water, 29% is land. Now, globe is a model of the Earth. Different landforms are plains, plateaus, and mountains, etc. Big land masses are called continents, and there are seven continents. We already read about them. Large water bodies are called oceans. So that concludes the reading of the lesson. I read the lesson, giving you some meanings in Telugu. Sorry, I taught the lesson, giving some. By pronouncing the words clearly, correctly, and then also gave you the meanings. So basically, in this, physical elements of the earth, we want to learn more about the earth. What is earth? Earth is comprised of land masses, land, and seas. And we tisukunte sea lo tisukunte say samudralu tisukunnamu, oceans tisukunnamu, and then seas we talked about, and also Land law, there are several places. We talked about Asia, the continents, so even you would have mattered. So, and also I told you about a map. Map is a diagrammatic representation of a piece of land and water bodies, highlighting all the other features like seas, rivers, mountains, etc. Then I also told you about a globe. Globe is the closest form that represents the Earth. It is, globe is round, similarly Earth is round. And also talked about the directions, north-south directions. Every map has to have direction, north-south directions. North is on the top, is up in the northern part, is the upper part is the north, lower part is south, and on the east side, and on the right-hand side it is east, and on the left-hand side is the west. I told you about that. Then also I told you about the latitudes and longitudes. There are lines going from east to west or north to south. The east to west, because it has A, I will say they are called as latitudes, and north to south, O, therefore they are called as a longitude. Therefore, not, I should not say therefore. I am telling you a technique. Sometimes I myself get it out. Whether east-west is called longitudes or latitude. That's what I'm saying. Easy east to west. So east to A on the, so it is latitude under actually. North-south law, O on the, therefore they are called as longitudes. Longitudes are O on the. So I hope you understood the lesson. And we had some problem with the power supply. Initially we had power, later on we lost the power. So we counted on the natural power, and you know what? Just now we got the electric power. So, you see the difference between when there is power and when there is no power. But normally, I think you should be all right. Whatever we recorded, Madam has recorded for you guys, it should be all right. So, if you like it, share it with somebody. And I certainly appreciate and thank you very much for giving me opportunity. Like I said, I'm not very that good in social studies. When I studied in my student career, in a student days, I always have trouble following social. But now I'm learning. While when I want to teach you, I have to know for sure. So I'm learning, and I thank God for giving me the opportunity to learn. Like Nehru says, life is a learning process from the point you are born till you die. And thank you very much. Bye-bye.